people are buying iPads in numbers that have been never before seen. Never. Nothing has exploded this much. Venue theory has caused a massive problem in our industry, in the information selling industry. With every massive problem, there is an even more massive opportunity. In a few moments, we're going to show you exactly how to exploit this situation. But first, let me show you the problem. In just 5 years, the app economy has changed everything. Joe and Jane Smith expect an amazing experience for the price of a cup of coffee. Trying to sell a $2,000 course on the iPad is just not going to cut it. Even worse, if your production values and design are not top shelf, you're, I believe the technical term, stuffed. Overlay this and you are trying to compete with the attention of 1 million, literally, other apps. To make matters worse, Joe and Jane Smith are not spending the time they used to in front of their desktop. More and more of our customers are buying iPads as their primary device. Trying to deliver the products that were so successful for us on the PC are unwieldy and they just don't fit. We have to rethink everything we need to figure out what's the music to fit in this venue. Look, it's not your fault. We've seen this with every major shift in media. So what works? What fits with this amazing opportunity? How do we get noticed amongst millions of apps? How will we do it without spending a fortune getting ourselves noticed? I'm glad you've asked. Let me show you. You're looking at the little blue books. This was the internet of the Great Depression, in railway stations and newsstands all around the United States. These little books sold the equivalent of $15 billion worth in today's money. In the midst of abject poverty, these little books informed, educated, and entertained people for an amount of money that most could afford. Does that sound familiar? And around the same time, magazines took off and made the 1930s equivalent of stupid money. A magazine could deliver all the news on a certain topic. The people who ran magazines became incredibly powerful and influential and filthy rich. If the internet was a problem for the magazine industry, the iPhone and the App Store were an extinction-level event. If people were bored or needed information, they whipped out their smartphone. This was a disaster for the magazine industry. But then something happened. Specifically, this happened. In 2011, Apple created a special section of the App Store called the Newsstand, a special place on the home screen of everyone's iOS device for magazines. For the first time, magazine publishers and no one else. You can't do any of this with a normal app on the App Store. You can subscribe with one button click, and Apple takes care of all the billing. With email getting harder and harder to deliver, push notifications, think text messages for apps, are the future. And in a later video, we're going to show you some jaw-dropping stats. Whoa, yes, you just saw it. Apple lets magazine publishers, and only magazine publishers, not any other app developer, get email addresses and location information with the reader's permission. People have been prepared to pay for information on the stuff they love for hundreds of years. And trust me, they're going to do it for hundreds more years in the future. It's just the venue has changed. Thanks to the power of Apple's Newsstand and the extraordinarily massive market they have made.